Hi, this is Jeff Heaton. Welcome to Applications of Deep Neural Networks with Washington University. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install the software necessary for this class on a Macintosh computer. Now, there's a sister video that goes along with this for Windows. I'm going to show you how to install TensorFlow, Keras, and Python together to work with Jupyter Notebooks. Even if you're not a student of my class, you can still see how to get this platform up and running so that you can use it for deep learning and machine learning on your own. And if you're interested in artificial intelligence, machine learning, Kaggle, and other fun stuff, please subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon. Okay, let's install Python and TensorFlow. This is the 2019 version of this video. Sometimes changes in the versions will require additional instructions, particularly what version of Python you're installing and what version of TensorFlow. TensorFlow 2.0 is coming out pretty soon, so this will probably make some changes. So I may re-record this video, or I may have additional information to give you. Always look at the comments, and I'll have a pinned comment near the top that will tell you if there's any version specific changes that have come about, or if I've replaced this with a new video altogether. But I always keep this very current because I teach a class on this every semester. I'm going to suggest that you install first Python. Now, Macintoshes do come with Python already installed, but it's an old version that is standard Python. You want to use Anaconda Python. So if you go to it and you just type Python --version, you'll see that you do have Python 2.7.10. Now Python 2 has a life unto its own, but Python 3 is the one that I align my classes to and the one that I recommend. So we're going to install Anaconda Python 3. This Python 2.7 that your Mac came with will remain there in the background. There is software that needs it for certain things, so don't delete it unless you're just really needing disk space and willing to go with all the headaches that will cause you. So don't delete it. We're going to install something called Miniconda. So just go to Google and search for Miniconda. So Miniconda, and go to this page. Now, you'll notice that the version that you can download is Python 3.7. This may have changed if you're watching this video at a later date. I recommend installing whatever the latest version that they have here is. But the thing that you've got to be aware of is TensorFlow doesn't always support the latest version of Python. Right now, in January 2019, the latest version TensorFlow requires Python 3.6. What you're going to do is download Python 3.7 and we'll create a Python 3.6 instance inside of it, environment, that you'll be able to use. Now this will change as new versions of TensorFlow come out, so I would at least look down at the comments. It could be that Python 3.7 is now supported by TensorFlow when you're watching this. So I always keep the most up-to-date information on that top comment that I always pin, so look for it there. Okay, so download the PKG installer. You could download the Bash installer, but this is the easier one to install. So once you get the PKG installer, this will come down. And by the way, Miniconda versus Anaconda, Anaconda in theory has everything you would ever need for Python, but it's very gigantic, whereas Miniconda starts minimal and you add on as you need. I prefer Miniconda. And once it's downloaded, you can pretty much just click that to launch the package file. Click continue, continue, accept the license, and continue, agree. It's good to install this in the standard location. That's where I always put it. Okay, it's completely installed, so we can close this window. And might as well throw the package in the trash. Okay, let's start up a new terminal window by clicking on the terminal. You might not have a terminal in your bar, you can always click find and type terminal. So now if we do Python version, you see we have 3.7.1. This is due to the fact that we have installed Anaconda 3.7. Now you're going to want to navigate to my course website because I've got some useful commands that you can copy and paste to get this working. Just Google Jeff Heaton Wustl, W-U-S-T-L. It's the school that I teach this class through. Click on the T81-558 Applications of Deep Learning. This is my course page at Washington University. Scroll down to the GitHub, and all the instructions you want are in module 1. We're going to download the entire course in a moment, but for now we just want to follow the instructions. If you scroll down a bit, you'll see software installation. Well, we already did this Miniconda part, so that's fine. This is dealing with the incompatibility between TensorFlow, the latest version, and Python 3.7. I'll yank this part if that becomes not necessary with continuing versions of TensorFlow, but if you see this here, still here, you still need to do this. Even if you're doing this or not, I recommend creating an environment in Anaconda that you will use just for TensorFlow. In my day job as a data scientist, I do this all the time. I have all sorts of environments created on my work computer that I use for various things. You can literally just copy this. This will create an environment called TensorFlow. This takes a moment, so we'll time lapse. So now that's installed, from your terminal window, let's go ahead and do the source. Now they will tell you to do conda activate, but we're gonna do source activate TensorFlow. That command is right here on my browser. Now we're in TensorFlow, and you can see as a result of that, very important that you do that step. And next we're going to install Jupyter. Conda install Jupyter. This is the notebook we'll use. I'll time lapse this. This can take a moment. All right, now that is installed. The next command down, Jupyter notebook, that's what you do to start the notebook. Let's skip that for now because not everything's installed yet. I am going to now execute these commands one by one. So this will, I'm going to time lapse this. I'll stop when we get to TensorFlow because that's where things can get interesting. But the rest of these should just install without much issue. If you did install Anaconda instead of Miniconda, you might have some issues with PSUtil. If PSUtil gives you, that's this one right here, if that gives you some issues, you can skip it. It's only used for one example, which is showing how powerful your machine is, which is a little bit further down. But let's go ahead and time-lapse this as I install these one by one. By the way, on one of these, like requests, you might see something where it says requirement already satisfied. It's perfectly fine. That just means that one of the previous packages already installed that. Okay, so we do get an error on PSUtil. If you get this error where it says XC run on the Mac, that's perfectly fine. You don't need PSUtil. I use that mainly to detect GPU cards, which is difficult on the Mac. So all of this is running CPU only, not GPU. GPU for TensorFlow requires a NVIDIA video card, and Macs typically come, the newer ones, newer within the last 3 to 4 years, come with AMD. So it's very hard to use GPU on a Macintosh with TensorFlow unless you're literally doing some sort of an external GPU enclosure. So we'll skip the PSUtil one for now. Don't worry if you do get an error on PSUtil. I'll probably put a note in here too just to make sure that people realize that. Now, let's install TensorFlow. If anything's going to go wrong, this is where it'll go wrong. So TensorFlow, here I have the double equal 1.12.0. For that one, you don't need to put the double equal if you're not in my class. That just locks you down to a specific version of TensorFlow. But if you get an error saying the TensorFlow can't be found, usually that is going to mean that you installed 3.7 of Python or you didn't create that environment. TensorFlow requires 3.6, at least as of January 2019. Now, if this changes, I'll update these instructions accordingly, and definitely look at that top pinned comment on this video and definitely subscribe. That's how you'll get updates to this stuff. This stuff changes like crazy. I'll time-lapse this. TensorFlow takes a moment. All right, happiness is when it says successfully installed TensorFlow. If you got errors installing TensorFlow, I would suggest Googling those errors, what others might have encountered. The usual suspects, if it told you that it simply could not find TensorFlow, that means that either you're on a 32-bit environment, which probably would not be possible on a Mac, you've installed a version of Python that is not compatible with TensorFlow. Those are the two usual suspects where people run into problems. If you run into something else, post something in the in the comments here, I'd love to see if any other things are happening. This is how stuff gets on my radar, and I'll try to help you at least as best I can. I monitor the comments on my channel. And next, Keras. If you successfully install TensorFlow, Keras is most likely going to work. By the way, in 2.0 of TensorFlow, which is coming, they're combining the two. So TensorFlow and Keras will. All right, let's do a real quick test. This is not in the instructions on the web, but you can very quickly do this. If you type Python, now you're in the Python environment. Do import TensorFlow as TF. Okay. Silence is bliss here. If it doesn't tell you anything back, it's working. But just to really check it, do print tf dot underbar underbar version underbar underbar 1.1.2. If you see this, congratulations, you have successfully installed TensorFlow, at least command line. We're going to do one more command to install it so it hooks up to Jupyter. This last command here, this is very important if you want it to work with Jupyter. What this does is we've created this new environment called TensorFlow that holds TensorFlow. This links it up so the Jupyter notebook can find it. If you don't have this, you're going to have issues running this in Jupyter notebook. And just like that, it is set up. So now, for the next step, we're going to download all the examples from my class, and we're going to run a few things just to verify that everything is up and running. Let's go back to my GitHub repository. Now, you don't need to be signed in or anything for this. Go ahead and star my repository, and that way you'll get notified and watch it if you want to be notified of changes, because I change this often as technology evolves. I would suggest do this. If you know what you're doing with Git, you can clone it. I would just download the zip. Okay, and the zip file is downloaded. You see it there, just double click it, it'll extract. Okay, let's open a new Finder and go home. So that is those are my directories, my home directory. I am going to copy this over to here, or move it actually. Move, copy, either one will be just fine. Now we'll go back to the terminal window, and I'm going to actually exit my terminal window and re-enter it just so you can see what this looks like when you're starting up from scratch. Each time that you reboot your computer or something, there's the terminal window. Make it a little bigger so it's easy to see. Okay, if we do pwd, which is Unix print, that's my working directory. You'll want to do a cd and change. Well, before we do any of that, even we do source activate TensorFlow should always be the first thing you do. That way, you are now in the TensorFlow Python environment. If you skip that, you're going to be in your base environment, which is Python 3.7. And doesn't even have TensorFlow installed. So then we're going to do cd t81 master. That's the name of my that course video or that course folder that you downloaded. And once you're here, you can do Jupyter. Make sure to spell Jupyter, JUPYTER, notebook. And you should see something that looks just like this. Now you'll notice this is a web page. And this terminal window that you had before, this is now a web server basically that's driving this. It is running completely through a browser. So here, your computer's driving it, but this could be a really powerful machine somewhere on the in the cloud. Like AWS SageMaker is something that I frequently use for this when I need a lot of processing power. They have a instance that has eight of the highest power GPUs that you can get, and it's about $37 an hour. So it's not cheap, but it makes that technology accessible. Alrighty, so let's go and open up class one. Now, this will frequently pop up. You'll see something like this. This means that it could not find the kernel that I originally built this with, and that makes sense. I probably created this in a different environment than what you have set up. You'll want to click this and you want to make sure you go to Python 3.6 TensorFlow. If you don't see Python 3.6 TensorFlow, then that means you probably didn't do that last command that I gave you where I told you the command to link it to Jupyter, to link your new environment named TensorFlow. So we're going to do that. We're going to set the kernel. It'll say kernel ready. Don't worry about not trusted. This thing has real trust issues. I actually don't know what that is even for. All right. Zoom this a little bit. So every time you're running one of my course modules, you'll want to run this helpful functions section. You'll get an error if you don't have TensorFlow or some other things installed, but it looks like it ran just fine, so that is good. We will scroll down to this part. This will print out all the versions. Here you can see where I ran it. This is not your output, you haven't ran it yet. So you're going to run this and hopefully you will see that you have TensorFlow 1.12 installed. Beautiful. This completes the installation for this. You now have a Jupyter Notebook environment ready on your Mac to tackle my course or other machine learning TensorFlow problems that you're going to go after.